Hello people, welcome to this video. We will see here how to apply filling and materials on 3D objects and how to render your projects with AutoCAD 2016. Please leave feedback to improve our future guides. In our previous videos, we have seen how to fill 2D objects using the hatch command. When you move to 3D objects, this tool does not work fine anymore, since you are able to fill just a basis or any parallel face to it. Plus, the filling created is still a 2D object. A 3D object is composed by wireframes, such as sides and vertices, that you can check with the 2D wireframe or the wireframe view, and the faces that are visible if you use any 3D view, like the realistic one. You can personalize both of them in different ways. If you want to give to a 3D object a uniform color to all its edges and faces, simply select the whole object and change its color going to Home and then to Properties. To color sides and edges shown in the wireframe views, go to Solid Editing under the 3D Tools panel and then to Color Edges. Select the edges one by one, press Enter key and decide the color to give to them. Choose Index Color to pick a quick list of colors, or click on the True Color tab to be more precise. To color faces instead, you can use color faces inside Solid Editing. The procedure is equal to the one seen for the edges before. With the tools inside the Solid Editing, you can define just one color per time, so apply this tool more than once if you want to give to faces or edges different colors. In professional projects, you usually need to fill objects using materials representing grass, bricks, or a roof structure. This is quite useful for the final render of your project, used to present your work when it's done. All that is used to apply materials and render your project is inside a section called Visualize that is hidden by default. Simply right-click on a vacant space on top, go to Show tabs, and click on Visualize to make it appear. In Materials, you have all settings to apply and edit materials. The first button opens the Materials browser that lists all materials that AutoCAD has. Before applying a material on an object, you must import it into your project first. By default, your project has just one material included, called Global. To import other materials, just hover a material and click on one of the two buttons on the right to add it to the list on top. You can also check and edit each material imported in your project, double-clicking on one in the list. This will open the Materials Editor, where you can edit the material name, its color and style. Use the small black arrow on the right side of the preview to change the kind of sample. When you finish, just close the editor. All the material settings will be saved. You can also rename or delete an imported material, right-clicking on it. To apply a material on an object, select it, and then click once on the imported material you want to apply to it. Mind to use a 3D rendered view or you won't see any material. You can also apply materials to one face only. Just hold Ctrl down to select one face per time, and then click once on the material you want to apply. All materials applied may be shown badly with low resolution. In these cases, you need to install the Medium Image Library. If you type render in the command line and press Enter, you can download and install this library from the dialog box that appears. Let's see now how to render your project. Although the realistic view is very good, it does not include all the full details like a full render of your project. To start rendering, simply click on the T button in the middle of the Visualize panel. AutoCAD needs some little time to complete the rendering. You can check its progress through the render progress bar percentage. It is rendered what is shown in your workspace at the moment you click on the render button, taking all objects present and also the point of view chosen in the view cube, like a screenshot. AutoCAD saves each render made on your project inside a list more below, clicking on the down arrow. You can also save a selected rendering made, clicking on the save icon on top. You can also set the zoom or print the rendering. Moreover, you can adjust the render settings going to the render section. Click on the first bar to adjust the render quality. The higher it is, the more additional time you need to wait to perform the rendering. Click below the T icon to set the pixel resolution. You can adjust other settings clicking on the arrow in the right corner. Through the second bar, you can select different ways to render your project. Choose Window to open the rendering done in another window, as seen before. Choose Viewport to render directly on your main workspace. Choose Region to render just a selected area on the workspace. Mind that if you render directly on the workspace using Viewport or Region, you won't be able to save your rendering, since this is lost when you move or edit something on the workspace. To improve the final rendering on your project, it can be useful to add any environment, light or sky. To add sunlight, click on Sun Status in Sun and Location. Apply the recommended settings that AutoCAD suggests, and a new window called Render Environment and Exposure appears. Here, you can adjust the general exposure and turn on environment to add a general sunlight that you can edit through image-based lighting. Plus, if you click on Sun and Location, you decide what kind of sunlight you prefer based on the date chosen and the hour or geographic location. You can also add shadows on object in Lights section. Choose Ground Shadows to show just the shadows on the ground, often used where you have sunlights only. Choose Full Shadows if you want to show ground shadows and also all other shadows that can appear between objects. You can also add secondary light sources. Point adds a light with a point as a source. This spreads in any direction, so you simply have to decide where to place it, clicking on your workspace and then using Enter key. Such point is shown as a small orange sphere on your workspace. If you choose a spot, you will add a spotlight, a light source with a defined direction. Simply fix where to place the origin and then a second point to fix the light direction. Use Enter to apply. You can adjust such light source selecting it and using the triangles to set the radius and the feather of the light edges. The spotlight does have a target that is kept even if you move the light. You can adjust the target simply moving the central blue square. There are some settings that can be applied to any kind of light source selected. You can set all general settings going to lights. To move any light source, select it first and use its gizmo system. If you want to add a light source from an infinite distance, use distant. This is a kind of light source very similar to the sun. There is also web light to add special non-uniform light sources. Try it. To complete the render, you just need to add sky and horizon. To do this, turn off environment from sun status and active the perspective view going on the bottom corner icon that appears when hovering the 3D view cube. This adds the horizon to your project. This is fixed even if you rotate the Cartesian system. Add sky clicking on sky off on top. To add other things in detail, like grass or streets, you have to make them. When you are ready, just render again. Thanks for watching. Check out our full guide for AutoCAD 2016 for more.